sonic guy might be giving the party to the hillside again.
I I I
targeted towards Dunlap.
Thank you.
bother you? Get off of there! Get off of there! 5B. Get down. Samantha, get down. What are you doing? What are you trying to do? Mama, go back that way. Samantha. You can see the frequencies.
You wanna go out?
What do you want, Hopi?
Out? Out. Come on. Out. Want
They went back into their apartment. Could have been 404.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, shoot, I know what I need to do.
Well, Peppa, you know I'm watching by.
state is where it was, so when I went to MTO, my shredder was just at the bottom. But the, that, I got my shredder.
They got a motion made for the end. I got a motion.
Mommy! Hi, my puppy!
Hi, my puppy!
How are you?
Thank you. surfacing. It's one of the oldest political sayings. If you want a friend in Washington, get a dog. Joe Biden got a dog, and the poor, mangy old thing won't stop sinking his teeth into the ankles of Secret Service agents. The dog, that is, not Joe. Says the man is known to millions, as the dog whisperer has seen on television screens in every corner of this earth. But he joins us now on the phone. Cesar, your view is that this is all caused not by the dog, but by tension in the White House.
Well, you know, animals do react from the energy and the environment. But this is a perfect example of not having a safety protocol to introduce dogs into the White House. Right, so it's the same protocol for any house. It's accident happens because there's no safety protocol. So we can't blame the dog. The first thing we have to understand is we can't blame the dog. We have to take full responsibility of how to introduce a dog into an environment first. And they introduce the dog into this new people. So you gain the trust, the respect, and the love. Then you have partners.
Would you have a situation? By his owner every day. He's being walked by government dog walkers who are Secret Service agents. Doesn't that complicate the situation?
Absolutely not. That makes it more social. He has more friends. There's a big opportunity here. If everybody understands the same thing and practices the same behavior, everybody's going to be major best friends. So this is it takes a village to raise a child. So this is where the village, if they do the same thing, if they have agreement, commitment, and follow through, everybody's going to speak dog. So that way, everybody can connect, communicate. The reason why I can help a dog anywhere in the world is because it's the same language. It's just in the White House, or in your house, or in my house, we have to learn to speak dog in order for a dog.
I love rescue dogs, but do you think when you're bringing a rescue dog into a government facility, as you said, a very tense place, one of the most stressful places on earth, I would imagine, do you think a rescue dog has different challenges there?
No, because we all have issues. We all come with issues. You know, after 20 years, people have issues. So a rescue dog means the dog that has issues and then was placed into a shelter.
As opposed to people terms, the Secret Service and all the other human beings around this dog can actually get into being a socialized member of the White House team. That's heartening to know. Actually, thank you for that, Cesar, the dog whisperer, joining us on the phone.
Right up to him and nabbing at his jacket sleeve. Les soon adopted the cub, now named Ben, and they've become the pair. The fox is now too tame to be let back into the wild, so now after being nursed back to health, Les moved Ben right into his home. and even has a playhouse with toys, his own bed, and is pretty much Les' shadow because he follows him everywhere. But after a year, the fox had to go back to the sanctuary because he was sent to share his enclosure with a female fox. Ben does still visit Les on the weekends, though he hates to leave. Les said, "At the end of every weekend at home with me, Ben sulks like a stroppy teenager when I have to take him back to the sanctuary." And because of this magical story, Les is in the process of getting his book, Ben's Magic Tale, published, and will help raise money for the Fox Angels charity.
Hey girl, here. You want a toy? You want a toy? You want a toy? No, no, no. Get your toy. Get your toy. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Get your toy. Get your toy. She just jumped in there. I'm trying to get her on video doing it again.
She's like, what's wrong?
This is how we shop for dog toys.